Welcome to ASHA's IAS Institute. In this video, we are going to discuss MCQs, to be specific, 30 MCQs based on the entire NCERT Class 11 textbook, Living Craft Traditions of India. Also, the textbook has already been covered. There's a separate video which has been uploaded earlier, completely covering the text. So all important points in the text have been discussed in this video, which I'm talking of is about a 1 hour video. So if you have gone through the video and covered important points in the entire text, then this MCQ test will be very easy for you, hopefully. And this test is 30 MCQs completely based on the book. We'll start with it. So, first question, consider the following statements. Number one, Kammalars, a caste group from Tamil Nadu, claim descent from the five divine artisan sons of Vishwamitra and follow the Shilpa Shastras. Second statement, Shilpa Shastras are technical texts on the practice of art in Tamil. Which of the statements given above are correct? A. One only. B. Two only. C. Both one and two. D. Neither one nor two. And your 10 seconds start now. And the correct answer is D. Neither one nor two. There is a mistake in the statement given here, you can see. So you have to be able to identify that incorrect statement. So, Kammalars are caste group from Tamil Nadu. They claim descent from the fine divine artisan sons of Vishwakarma, not Vishwamitra. So, this is the mistake. Vishwamitra was a sage and this is about Lord Vishwakarma. Kammalars are actually also known as Vishwakarmas. And Shilpa Shastra are technical texts on the practice of art in Sanskrit. The question mentioned Tamil. So, Shilpa Shastras are in Sanskrit. So, these are important texts in art. Ancient texts of India. Then coming to the next question, question number two. Sholapith craft is traditionally practiced in India in the state of A. Bihar, B. Orissa, C. Assam, D. West Bengal. And your 10 seconds start now. And the correct answer is D, West Bengal. So here you can see this is Sholapith craft. Sholapith is actually a dried, milky white, spongy plant matter from Asiomene species. So it can be pressed and shaped into objects of art. And it has been used in Bengal since time immemorial. It is also considered of divine origin and considered auspicious and pure. Used during religious and social functions. That is Sholapith from West Bengal. Coming to question number three, paper mache is used as an economic building material for a variety of traditional and ceremonial activities as well as in arts and crafts. What is the main component of paper mache? A. Paper or pulp. B. Cotton or jute. C. An alloy of mercury. D. Brass or bronze. And your 10 seconds start now. And the correct answer is A, paper or pulp. So, paper mache actually literally means chewed paper, pulp paper or mashed paper. And it's a composite material consisting of paper pieces or pulp. And sometimes it is reinforced with textiles bound with an adhesive such as glue, starch or wallpaper paste. This substance has been used in China since 200 BC. And in India also, paper mache items are quite famous from Kashmir. So, they are known all over the world. Paper mache products from Kashmir. Then coming to question number four, consider the following statements. Terracotta seals as well as toys have been found belonging to Harappan civilization. Two, Ayyanar horse of Tamil Nadu is a huge terracotta horse placed within temple premises. Which of the statements given above is correct? A. One only. B. Two only. C. Both one and two. D. Neither one nor two. And your 10 seconds start now. And the correct answer is C. Both the statements are actually true. What is terracotta? You should know. It is actually clay, which is transformed by by baking it. So it's baked clay. So once the clay is dried in the sun and fired in a local kiln, terracotta is formed. And once fired, terracotta becomes insoluble, unplastic, and durable. And terracotta seals have been found from Harappan civilization, as well as here you can see this is a terracotta horse in the Ayyanar temple, in the premises of Ayyanar temple in Tamil Nadu. This is also made of terracotta. Then next, fifth question. Consider the following statements regarding descent of Ganga in Mahabalipuram, Tamil Nadu. One, it is a relief that was created to celebrate the victory of Narasimhavarman I of Ganga dynasty over Chalukyan king Pulakeshin II. Two, it is carved on two monolithic rock boulders of sandstone. Which of the statements given above is are correct? A, one only. B, two only. C, both one and two. D, neither one nor two. And your 10 seconds start now. And the correct answer is D. Both the statements are incorrect. The mistakes you should know. Descent of Ganga in Mahabalipuram, Tamil Nadu. It is a relief that was created to celebrate victory of Narasimhavarman I of Pallava dynasty. It is mentioned Ganga dynasty there. So it is Pallava dynasty over Chalukyan king Pulakeshin II, and it is carved out of two monolithic rock boulders. It is two rock boulders which have been used to carve this descent of Ganga in Mahabalipuram, but it is on granite, boulders of granite, not of sandstone. Then coming to question number 6, the Kailash temple, a huge monolithic temple carved from a rock cliff face, is at A, Ajanta Caves, Maharashtra. B, Ellora Caves, Maharashtra. C, Bharut Caves, Madhya Pradesh. D, Barabar Caves, Bihar. And your 10 seconds start now. And the correct answer is B, Ellora Caves. This is the monolithic Kailash temple. It has been completely carved out from a single rock boulder. These are Ellora Caves in Maharashtra. Then seventh question. Consider the following statements. One, Vihara is a Buddhist shrine or temple hall with a stupa at one end. Two, Chaitya is a monastery or residential place of Buddhist priests. Which of the statements given above is are correct? A, one only. B, two only. C, both one and two. D, neither one nor two. And your 10 seconds start now. And the correct answer is D, neither one nor two, because they have been interchanged. This is generally the way UPSC also asks questions. So Vihara is actually a monastery and Chaitya is a Buddhist shrine or temple hall with stupa at one. Then next, question number 8. Which among the following is are incorrectly paired? So one, Sun Temple, Konark. Two, Jagannath Temple, Bhubaneswar. 3. Brihadeshwar Temple, Thanjavur. Select the correct answer from the codes given below. A, 1 only. B, 1 and 3 only. C, 2 only. D, all the above. And your 10 seconds start. And the correct answer is C, 1 and 3 only. So you can see Jagannath Temple is not in Bhubaneswar. Jagannath Temple is in Puri in Odisha. Lingaraj Temple is in Bhubaneswar in Odisha. All three, first three temples mentioned are from Odisha. Sun Temple, Jagannath Temple and Lingaraj. Sun Temple, Konark, Jagannath Temple, Puri and Lingaraj Temple, Bhubaneswar. This is very important. And Brihadeshwar Temple is in Thanjavur in Tamil Nadu. That is correctly there. Then the next question. अष्ट धातु लिटरली एट मेटल्स इज एन अलॉय ऑफन यूज फॉर कास्टिंंग मेटालिक आइडल्स इन जैन एंड हिंदू टेम्पल्स इन इंडिया. विच अमंग द फॉलोइंग इज नॉट वन ऑफ इट्स कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंट एलिमेंट्स, नॉट वन ऑफ द एट मेटल्स. सो द फोर ऑप्शंस आर ए मर्क्यूरी, बी एल्यूमिनियम, सी जिंक, डी टिन. एंड योर 10 seconds स्टार्ट नाउ. And the correct answer is B, aluminium. So, Ashtadhatu is an alloy of 8 metals. The metals which are used are gold, silver, lead, iron, tin, copper, zinc, and mercury or antimony. So, aluminium is not part of it. Then next is question number 10. Consider the following statements. 1. The lost wax technique is an ancient technique which is no longer known to our civilization. 2. The earliest example of lost wax technique is from the Indus Valley civilization. 3. The bronze dancing girl of Mohenjo-daro was made using the lost wax technique. So, which of the statements given above is our correct? 1 only, B 1 and 2 only, C 2 and 3 only, D all the above. And your 10 seconds start now. And the correct answer is C. So, what is was incorrect here, you should know in the first statement is lost wax technique is actually known. The earliest example of lost wax technique is from Indus Valley civilization. The statement is correct and this was actually an amulet. So, 6,000 year old amulet from which is like a taviz, which is worn around the neck or the shoulder. So, that is an amulet which has been found, which is made of using lost wax technique. So, that's the earliest example of lost wax technique, which is from Indus Valley civilization. And the bronze dancing girl of Mohenjo-daro is also made using lost wax technique. This is the bronze dancing girl. Also, later civilizations, also later Gupta period also, lost wax technique was known. Shilpa Shastra speak in detail about it. So, it is not actually a lost technique. The technique is not lost. In the method, wax is lost. So, it is a method of metal casting in which hot metal is poured into a wax model, which is lost during the process. So, that is why it is called lost wax technique. So, the first statement was incorrect that it is ancient technique, yes, but it is known to our civilization. It is not lost. Then, coming to 11th question. Consider the following statements regarding Bidriware. 1. It is a metal handicraft from Bidar in Andhra Pradesh. 2. It was developed in the 14th century CE during the reign of Vijayanagar Empire. 3. It is made of zinc and copper inlaid with pure silver. So, this is copper. So, which of the statements given above is our correct? A. 1 and 2 only. B. 3 only. C. 2 and 3 only. D. All the above. And your 10 seconds start now. And the correct answer is B. So, third statement is correct. It is made of zinc and copper inlaid with pure silver. The first two statements are incorrect. And the mistakes here is Bidar is not in Andhra Pradesh. Bidar is in Karnataka. Even the text, NCERT text mentions Bidar in Andhra Pradesh, but that's completely incorrect. And also, it was developed in the 14th century during the rule of Bahamani Sultans, not in the Vijayanagar Empire. So, that is there. And of course, Bidriware is made of zinc and copper inlaid with silver. Then coming to question number 12. Consider the following statements. 1. Paper came to India with Muslim traders in the 11th century. 2. There is no original Sanskrit word for paper. 3. The Chinese word for paper is kogzi, from which the Persian word for paper, kagaz, is adopted. Which of the statements given above is our correct? A. 1 and 2 only, B 2 and 3 only, C 3 only, D all the above. And your 10 seconds start now. And the correct answer is D. All the statements given were correct. Paper came to India with Muslim traders in 11th century. and there is no original Sanskrit word for paper. The Chinese word for paper is kagzi, from which Persian word paper for paper, that is kagaz, is adopted. So all three statements given were correct. This is based on the content completely given in the NCERT text. You can refer to it. Then next is question number 13. The Sakth makers of Kashmir are experts in which of the following handicraft work? A. Pashmina. B. Carpet. C. Silverware. D. Paper mash. And your 10 seconds have started. And the correct answer is D, paper mash. So the process of paper mash making, as we had discussed earlier in our question 2, is famous from Kashmir, and it is undertaken by a group of people who are called Sakth makers. Then question number 14. Consider the following pairs: Chow dance style and location. So there are three major forms of Chow dance: Purulia Chow, Sarekela Chow, and Mayurbhanj Chow. So the pair given is Purulia Chow, Bengal; Sarekela Chow, Orisha; and Mayurbhanj Chow, Bihar. So which of the pairs given above is correctly matched is the question. The four options are A, one only; B, two only; C, one and two only; D, all the above. And your 10 seconds start now. And the correct answer is A. So only first Purulia Chow has been correctly paired. Purulia Chow is from Bengal. Seraikela Chow is from Jharkhand. And Mayurbhanj Chow is from Odisha. It was mentioned Seraikela is Odisha and Mayurbhanj Bihar. So that's incorrect. The correct pair is this. Then next, question number 15. Which among the following is not a silk variety from India? 1. Mulberry. 2. Tussar. 3. Moga. 4. Eri. Select the correct answer from the codes given below. A. One only. B. Four only. C. All the above. D. None of the above. And your 10 seconds start now. And the correct answer is D, none of the above. Because it says not a silk variety, and all four are silk variety from India. So none of them is not a silk variety. So there are four types of natural silk produced in India for commercial purposes. And these are mulberry silk, tussar silk, muga silk, and eri silk. Among these four kinds, mulberry silk contributes more than 80% of the silk produced in the country. Next, going to question number 16. Consider the following statements. 1. Indian textiles have been found in the tombs of Egyptian pharaohs. 2. Muga silk is a variety of wild silk geographically tagged to the state of Assam. 3. Tamil Nadu is the biggest producer of Tussar silk in India. Which of the statements given above is correct? A. 1 and 2 only. B. 2 and 3 only. C. 3 only. D. All the above. And your 10 seconds start now. So the correct answer is A, that is 1 and 2 are correct. Indian textiles have been found in the tomb of Egyptian pharaohs, and Muga silk is a variety of wild silk geographically tagged to the state of Assam. But Tussar silk, Tamil Nadu is not the biggest producer. Presently, Jharkhand has emerged as the biggest producer of Tussar silk in India. Then next, question number 17. Consider the following pairs: GI tagged product, geographical indication tagged product, and its location. 1. Kanjivaram sari, Tamil Nadu; brocade, Gujarat; Ikat silk sari, Assam. Which of the pairs given above are correctly matched? A. 1 only. B. 1 and 2 only. C. 1 and 3 only. D. All the above. And your 10 seconds start now. And the correct answer is A, 1 only. Kanjivaram sari is from Tamil Nadu. brocade is not from Gujarat, but brocade is from Uttar Pradesh, and ikat silk sari is from Orissa. And in Kanjivaram sarees, there's a little more information given here. As per GI label, geographical indication label, Kanjivaram sarees from Tamil Nadu should have 57% silver and 0.6% gold in zari. However, Tamil Nadu government has eased this to 40% instead of 57% silver and 0.5% gold to make life easy for its producers. The next is question 18. Consider the following statements. Shahtoosh is the animal hair obtained from the Tibetan Chiru antelope. 2. Pashmina is the animal hair fiber obtained from Changthangi mountain goat. Which of the statements given above is correct? A. 1 only. B. 2 only. C. Both 1 and 2. D. Neither 1 nor 2. And your 10 seconds start now. And the correct answer is C, both 1 and 2. Both the statements given are correct. Shahtoosh is the animal hair obtained from Tibetan Chiru antelope. So this is an antelope, you can say a wild animal. And Pashmina is from mountain goat, which is a goat. So Shahtoosh is actually banned. So in that context, you should remember that Shahtoosh is from Tibetan Chiru antelope. And it's now a banned item. Possession and sale is illegal in most countries because Chiru antelope is an endangered species under CITES, Convention on International Trade in Endangered Species. So, Shahtoosh is said to be the world's finest wooltoo, having the lowest micron count. Shahtoosh shawls are so fine that large shawls can be passed through a wedding ring. So, that is why they are also known as ring shawls. And Pashmina is animal hair fiber obtained from Changthangi mountain goat. Next, question number 19. Consider the following pairs, GI tagged product and location. 1. Kantha embroidery, Bihar. 2. Sujni embroidery, West Bengal. 3. Pipli applique, Orissa. Which of the pairs given above is correctly matched? A. 1 only. B. 3 only. C. 1 and 2 only. D. All the above. And your 10 seconds start now. And the correct answer is B. That is only third one is correctly matched. Pipli applique is from Orissa. Kantha embroidery is from West Bengal. And Sujani embroidery is from Bihar. So both have been incorrectly paired as such. Kantha should be West Bengal. Sujani Bihar. And the Pipli applique is from Orissa. That's correct. There is another form of embroidery called Kasuti embroidery from Karnataka. So these embroidery have been shown in the NCRT text. You can look up to it. Then question number 20 is, consider the following pairs, GI tag product and location. So such questions are quite often asked in UPSC. So there are quite large number of GI tag products in the country, but what have been covered in the NCRT text have been picked up for the questions here. So first one is Chanderi Sari, Uttar Pradesh. 2. Garhwal Sari, Himachal Pradesh. 3. Paithani Sari, Maharashtra. Which of the pairs given above is correctly matched? A. 1 only, B, 2 and 3 only, C, 3 only, D, all the above. And your 10 seconds start now. And the correct answer is C, 3 only. So, Paithani Sari is from Maharashtra, Chanderi Sari is from Madhya Pradesh, not Uttar Pradesh, and Garhwal Sari is not from Himachal Pradesh, it's from Telangana. So that's very important. So Garhwal, Himalayas, you hear of, that is different. Garhwal Sari is not from Himachal, it's from Telangana. Then question number 21, consider the following pairs, painting and location. So first one is Kalighat painting, West Bengal, Mithila painting, Uttar Pradesh, Madhubani painting, Bihar. Which of the pairs above is correctly matched? A. 1 only. B. 1 and 3 only. C. 2 and 3 only. D. All the above. And your 10 seconds. And the correct answer is B. So only 1 and 3 are correctly paired. Kalighat painting is from West Bengal. Madhubani painting is from Bihar. And Mithila painting is actually another name for Madhubani painting, that is from Bihar only. So it is known to have its origin in Mithila region of India and Nepal. Then next, question number 22. Manjusha art often referred to as snake paintings by foreigners, as swirling snakes in the art depict the central character Bihula's tale of love and sacrifice, are from the state of A. Bihar, B. Maharashtra, C. Orissa, and D. Rajasthan. So select the correct option and your 10 seconds start here. And the correct answer is A. Bihar. Even Manjusha paintings are from Bihar. Manjushas are an Indian art form. They are temple-shaped boxes, actually, comprising of 8 pillars, and they are made of bamboo, jute and paper. They also contain paintings of Hindu gods and goddesses. So these Manjusha boxes have Manjusha paintings, and these boxes are used in Bishahari Puja. That is the festival dedicated to snake god that is celebrated in Bhagalpur and nearby regions in Bihar. Then next is, Kalamkari, meaning pen work in Persian, is a GI tag, geographical indication tagged handicraft from A. Andhra Pradesh, B. Jammu and Kashmir, C. Uttar Pradesh, D. Rajasthan. And your 10 seconds start here. And the correct answer is A. Andhra Pradesh. Kalamkari, or also called Vrathpani, from Andhra Pradesh, demonstrates a variety of natural materials used to create the work of art. Kalamkari basically means pen work in Persian and refers to both printed and even painted cloth. Then next is question 24. Manjushri, representing Buddha's wisdom, Vajrapani, representing Buddha's power, and Padmapani or Avalokiteshvar, representing Buddha's compassion, are A. Bodhisattvas, B. Animals revered in Mahayana Buddhism, C. Amulets worn in Vajrayana Buddhism, D. Traits revered in Theravada Buddhism. And your 10 seconds start now. And the correct answer is A. Bodhisattvas. So these are the three prominent Bodhisattvas. These are Ajanta paintings of Padmapani and Vajrapani shown here. Then next, question number 25. Jaina paintings of Sittanavasal caves depicting a tank filled with lotus flowers and surrounded by bhavyas, that is the faithful, elephants, fishes, humans, etc. located in. So where are these Sittanavasal caves with Jaina paintings located? A. Tamil Nadu, B. Karnataka, C. Gujarat, or D. Rajasthan. And your 10 seconds start now. And the correct answer is A. Tamil Nadu. Sittavanasal Caves is a 2nd century Jaina complex of caves in Sittavanasal village in Pudukottai district of Tamil Nadu. The paintings depict beautiful lotus pond with lotus flowers, people collecting lotuses from the ponds, two dancing figures, lilies, fish, geese, buffaloes and elephants. So these are Jaina caves. Then question 26. Tholu Bommalatta is a form of puppetry from Andhra Pradesh. Which form of puppetry does it represent? A. String puppetry, B. Shadow puppetry, C. Glove puppetry, D. Rod puppetry. And your 10 seconds start now. And the correct answer is B. Shadow puppetry. Tholu Bommalatta is a shadow puppet theater tradition of the state of Andhra Pradesh. It literally means dance of leather puppets. Then coming to question number 27, consider the following pairs, the pairs of theatre and location. So first one is Nautanki. ए फर्स्ट नौटंकी फ्रॉम महाराष्ट्र, टू भवाई फ्रॉम गुजरात, थ्री यक्षगाना फ्रॉम कर्नाटक. सो विच ऑफ द पेयर्स गिवन अबव इज आर करेक्टली मैच्ड? ए वन ओनली, बी वन एंड थ्री ओनली, सी टू एंड थ्री ओनली, डी ऑल द अबव. सो योर 10 सेकेंड्स स्टार्ट हियर. And the correct answer is C. Nautanki is not from Maharashtra. Nautanki is from Uttar Pradesh. So 2 and 3 are correct. Bhavai is from Gujarat. Yakshagana is from Karnataka. But Nautanki is from Uttar Pradesh. Tamasha is the theater form from Maharashtra. Then the next question is, so this is, Kathakali is a dance form from the state of A, Tamil Nadu, B, Kerala, C, Karnataka, D, Uttar Pradesh. And your 10 seconds start here. And the correct answer, this is a very simple question, it's a classical dance form, Kathakali from Kerala. So, it is a story play genre of art, but one distinguished by an elaborately colorful makeup, costume and face masks that are traditionally male actor dancers wear. So traditionally it is done by male actors. Then next question 29. Sitar is a modified form of Meena developed by the famous Sufi scholar A. Hazrat Nizamuddin, B. Khwaja Moinuddin Chishti, C. Waris Ali Shah, D. Amir Khusro. And your 10 seconds start here. And the correct answer is D. Amir Khusro. So, Veena is the precursor of sitar. So, sitar was made from Veena. It has said to be invented or rather developed from Veena by Amir Khusro, the famous Sufi inventor, poet and pioneer of various other musical forms like khayal, tarana and qawwali during the 13th century. Then the last question. Which among the following are not a type of drum? 1. Chenda. 2. Pankhavaj, D. Mridangam, 4. Nagada. Select the correct answer from the codes given below. A. 1 and 2 only, B. 4 only, C. 2 and 3 only, D. None of the above. And your 10 seconds start now. And the correct answer is D. All four are types of drums. So here you can see Chenda is a cylindrical wooden drum from South India. It has a length of 2 feet and a diameter of 1 foot. It's widely used in Kerala, Karnataka and Tamil Nadu. It is famous for its loud and rigid sound. So all are types of drums from India. Chenda, Pankhavaj, Mridangam and Nagada. So that's it. Hope you did well. Out of 30 questions, at least you should get 15 questions correct. If you are taking it negative marking too, one-third negative marking is what we have for civil services examination. So at least out of 60, when per question has 2 marks score, at least you should get 50% in culture. So a little above 50% is a good score, and if it is less than that, then you have to work harder. And if you are getting more than that, it's great. So a little above 50% is the minimum essential which is required. Wishing you all the very best. Thank you.
Subscribe to our YouTube channel and press the bell icon for all the latest updates.